Okay, good afternoon to all of our viewers. We're back here in Grandison's Preso Lounge. And for today's video, of course, we have a very special event today, no? We will be having our 10,000 pesos cash reimbursement later for all of our June 2024 PTLE passers. Well, of course, there will only be one winner, no? So make sure that you have already liked and shared our page, and of course, sign up with the registration form to be found on the comment section. Yeah, and of course, before we proceed with the raffle draw, no, we will also have some special guests later, no? I-introduce ko sila later, no? But of course, no, to start the program, let me introduce myself. My name is Jody, and I am your host for today's Grandison's Preso Lounge. So this is your virtual coffee table. This is the place where we catch up with our PTs, OTs, nurses, and of course, some of our partners. Here, no, we appreciate or we welcome everyone, no, all of our team members to share their voice, no, to educate and also inspire other healthcare professionals, no, in the field. Yeah. And for today's segment, this is very special, no, because we will be interviewing some of our cum laudes to the United States, of course, together with one of our recruiters later on. Yeah. And to all of our viewers, no, can you say hi naman dyan or let us know, no, kung saan tayo nanonood for today. Yeah. Yeah. So hello, Christelle. Thank you for watching. Yeah, Kia, thank you for watching as well. Ayan. So make sure to share this to your peers as well, no? Who knows, no? Baka isa sa inyo ang mabunot later for the 10,000 pesos cash reimbursement. Ayan. And while we are waiting for the others to join, no, let me welcome, no, without any further ado, no, our Grandison recruiter for today, Miss Lori. Hello, Miss Lori.
And hi everyone. Hi Miss Jody. Good afternoon po.
Yeah, and welcome to Grandison's Preso Lounge, Miss Lori, no? And of course, no, let me introduce to you our special guests. Yan, with S, no? Kasi hindi lang isa. We have two special guests for today. And I think nakita nyo na rin sila kanina, no? While you were waiting.
Yes.
Nakita nyo na sila sa poster earlier, no? So let me first call on our first special guest from Angeles University Foundation, Miss April Jean. Hi, Miss April.
Hello po. Ayan.
Ayan. Welcome to Grandison's Preso Lounge, no? Salamat po sa papa-unlock na ma-interview namin kayo, no? So, Miss April, can you introduce yourself, no, to our viewers?
So, hello everyone. Hello sa mga viewers natin. Kung nasan man po kayo ngayon. And thank you for watching here in Grandison. So, I am April Chianti Studio, a graduate of BS Physical Therapy in Angeles University Foundation. And medyo proud to say cum laude.
Yes naman, cum
Thank
laude, no? Congratulations, no, Miss April Jan, cum laude and June 2024 PTLE passer. Yan, fresh na
Yes.
fresh pa from last month ang results.
Yes po.
Yan, thank you, Miss April. And of course, no, we also have another special guest. Let me call on Miss Laika May, magna cum laude from De La Salle. Hi, Miss Laika.
Good afternoon, madlang people char.
Yan. I love the energy, no? Yan. Gusto ko yung energy ni Miss April and Miss Laika, no? Yeah. Like Miss April, Miss Laika, can you also introduce yourself sa mga viewers natin?
I'm Laika May Erica Franca, PTRP, and I just graduate last year, magna cum laude sa De La Salle Medical and Health Sciences Institute, and I just passed the board exam last June 2024. Din po.
Wow, congratulations to both of you, Miss Laika and April, no, mga cum laude and magna cum laude and both June 2024 PTLE passers. Yan. And of course, no, hindi naman namin kayo iimbitahin without any special reasons, no. So for today, no, we want to ask you, no, kung bakit niyo ba napili ang United States, no. So meron kaming baon na questions ni Miss Lori, no, pinaghandaan namin yung interview namin sa inyo. But before that, no, syempre, may special banner din tayo sa taas. Yan, no? So, to all of our viewers, no, sa mga PTs natin who are watching right now, or OTs who are watching right now, no, you can avail of our special referral bonus right now, no? So, when you refer a physical therapist, no, you can earn up to 1,500 US dollars or up to 82,000 pesos, no, for every successful referrals. Yan. Of course, terms and conditions apply, no. So if you have any BSPT friends, no, especially those who just recently passed their boards last June and last December, no, just message us at Grandison Therapy, no? Or you can reach out to Miss Lori here. Yan. We also have a Google form attached sa aming comment section. You can also fill out the form, no? So that we can reach out to you, no, and talk to you about your referrals. Yan. So, excited ka na ba, Miss Lori, for the interview?
Ako, ma'am, excited na. Ewan ko po yung dalawa.
Okay, sige. Uumpisahan ko na. Ayan, uumpisahan ko na, no? So, I think the very first question, of course, hindi lang ako, no? Even, I think, yung mga batchmates ninyo and the other PTs na kakagraduate lang last year, no? And those who are about to graduate this year, no? Why US, no? Bakit Amerika ang napili ninyo? I think I'll start first with Miss April. Yeah, Miss April.
Yan. So, for me naman, ma'am, to work in the US is one of my goals na talaga ever since I started my journey as BS Physical Therapy in order to experience a world-class healthcare, kasi alam naman natin, iba talaga yung US, and a work-life balance din, healthy environment at the same time. Sa totoo, gusto din natin ang competitive salary talaga.
Of More course.
This would open, yes. This would open greater opportunity kasi not just for my personal growth and career, but also to help my family. So yun, yeah. Yung main reason.
Of course. So how about you, Miss Liga, no? Bakit Amerika?
Actually, I kind of agree po kay Ma'am April. Pero malay nyo maghanap ng AFAM. Char! Kidding aside.
Yes.
Not that ah. But this may sound cliche, but for me po kasi, since US, I want to step outside sa comfort zone ko. And I know na since US yon and progressive yung growth doon, yung career doon, feel ko, ma-found ko yung growth ko. Tsaka feel ko mas marami akong opportunities na makita. And compared here kasi sa Philippines, sadly, na parang syempre mas competitive yung salary sa US. And although I just feel stagnant kasi here sa Philippines, although I just stated that early kasi kakapasa ko lang ng boards and everything, pero I believe na for me kasi, gusto kasi mag-give back sa Philippines after. So, feel ko, mas makapag-give back ako kapag I'm already established and fully experienced na ma-acquire ko sa US. Ayun.
Yes. Thank you, Miss April and Miss Laika. No, I love that. No, of course, Miss April helping the family opportunity. Same with Miss Laika. Plus, the grandest give back. No, very grandest. On. Ayan, no. And I think, my next question would be, there are a lot of opportunities, no, in the United States. Some chose direct hire, mag-self-finance, no? So, what offer or what factors made Grandison Therapy stand out amidst the other competitors or options that you can take, no, for your US journey? Yan. Oh, sorry. I'll start with Miss Laika.
Sige. Okay. For me kasi, to be honest, pinag-isipan ko talaga kung mag-Grandison ako. Kasi Grandison, for me, sa situation ko right now, has the best offer. Kasi depende naman yan kung ano yung priorities mo, yung goals mo sa life. So, for me, syempre, you need to also assess ano ba yung goals mo, ano ba yung priorities mo, ano yung situation mo ngayon. Then, if it checks your ano ba yung criteria, then why not push din mag-Grandison, ganun. And for me kasi, each agency, kahit staffing man yan or direct hire, each of it naman po for me, may pros and cons. So, nasa tao na lang po yan kung paano nila yun i-outweigh. Depende nga po kung ano yung priorities nila and yung goals sa life. Ayan.
Yes, definitely agree. How about you, Miss J? Ano, is there any factor or offer ni Grandison that stood out and affected or influenced your decision?
Papa, medyo may hugot naman yung akin. Kasi for me,
Wow.
Grandison, yung Grand Scholarship, it answered all my hows and whys. Yan, hindi lang X and Ys. Pati yung how ko. Kasi unang-una, ang inisip ko, paano ako makakapuntang US samantalang wala naman akong relatives doon. So yun yung unang consideration ko. Next is that I always wonder how am I going to process the application? Kasi from review to exam to further studies, honestly, napakagas. Tos, nakakalula, parang ganon. And lastly, if by any chance I get there, paano naman ako makakasigurado na long term yung work engagement ko? So yun yung mga considerations ko, and I was so blessed to find Grandison and how Grandison find me also, na lahat yun nasagot. So it has given me hope, career growth, at saka assurance. Yun naman eh. Sa panahon ngayon, kailangan natin ng assurance.
Yeah, I love the hugot, no? Miss April, no?
Oh, and kailangan I think, assurance.
True, no? And I think that's also one of the challenges, no, ng other PTs who wants to migrate to the United States. I think may iba nag-choose ng self-finance. However, there are struggles in terms of the petitions, no, of course also the money, because hindi biro, no, yung amount that you need for you to be able to get to the United States. And I think, no, Miss Lori, may surprise question ako sa iyo, no. Ito tatanungin ko lang din kay Miss Lori, no, singit ko lang din, no. So how does Grandison help ba with the PTs, no, who wants to go to the United States, and medyo nag-iisip pa sila if magsa self finance ba ako or should I choose a staffing agency like Grandison?
Meron pala ako, ma'am. Oh my God. Hindi pala, hindi ako handa. Well, actually, ma'am, no, Grandison is really a big help for those PTs who's aspiring to advance their career in the US, mainly because when they choose Grandison, no, when it comes to the processing, the credentialing, and at the same time, financial aspects, no, wala nang poproblemahin yung mga PTs natin who are currently, no, joining Grandison, because it will be provided by Grandison, and at the same time, their main focus is just to review for the NPTE, no, and everything will be processed and financed by Grandison.
Wow, no, kumbaga mag-aaral ka na lang, no?
Yes.
No need to worry about the documents processing, the visa or anything. Just review and pass your NPTE, and of course your TOEFL din, no?
Yes,
no. And no, going back to our special guest, no, for today, no. So meron tayong cum laude and one magna cum laude, no. So ma'ams, no, or our PTs, no, how do you think this academic excellence can help you, no, in your future career in the United States? Yan. Unahin naman natin si Miss April. Ayan.
Salitan ba
natin? Yes, salitan.
For me naman, the good thing in people is that the more we learn kasi, the more we thirst for even greater. Same thing with achievements. I don't want to end it there. Ayoko na, tapos na doon yung mga na-achieve ko sa buhay. I want to pursue other opportunities in order to improve my knowledge, skills, and even character, especially to be molded in one of the top countries talaga in the world. So I think being a cum laude would help me a bit, yet it is always the character that would take me to greater heights.
Wow, very
misleading.
Thank you, Miss April. No, how about you, Miss Laika? No,
pwede pong quote ko na lang, char.
Okay.
I agree kay Ma'am April. Actually, yung magna cum laude, any Latin honors is just a title. Kasi pang short, for me, pang short term brag lang yan eh. In the long term, yung ugali mo pa din and how you see yourself in your career, kung paano ka magpo-progress and paano yung vision mo sa life, vision mo para sa patients mo, and it always there kasi yung mas okay, mas okay kapag mas may puso ka compared sa puro utak lang. Ganon.
Yes, no, and I think we can feel it from both of you, no? As early as now, nakikita na namin yung magandang future waiting for Miss April and for Miss Laika. Ayan. And by the way, Miss Laika, you have a fan here, no? Someone is saying hi. So, hello po kay Laika May, PTRP, magna cum laude. So, this is from shout out from Darren Niedo. Yan. Maybe you know him.
Ah, yes po. Best friend ko po yan.
Oh, best friend. Very supportive best friend, no? And of course, no, I think we're so happy right now kasi sobrang fresh pa, no, from passing the PTLE. Pero on a serious note, no, bigla ako naging seryoso, right? No, are there any specific concerns or anxieties na nararamdaman nyo right now about entering the US healthcare system as a Filipino physical therapist? Yan. Or do you have, what are your plans in terms of overcoming those as well? Ayan, I'll start with Miss Laika.
Feel ko, ano, lahat ng emotion sa inside out. Kasi ano eh, like siguro for me kasi sobrang leap of faith yung pagpunta sa US given na same kay Ma'am April na I also have no relatives sa US, nasa Canada pero sa US wala akong relatives doon, and I know na it's a normal response na ma-feel anxious sa gagawin mong hakbang sa buhay mo, but mas okay naman kesa hindi mo siya i-grab. So, as a personal risk taker, siguro for me, there's always a reason kung bakit ko siya the feel na i-grab. And yung anxiety na yan, sandali lang yan. Feel ko during the process, kahit pa paano mababawasan yon kasi may support system naman, and yung support system na yon nagbo-boost ng confidence mo na parang kaya mo yan, syempre ganun po. And then kung meron ka pong support system kapag nasa US ka na and you know how to socialize, and since character pa rin nga po yung magdadala sa'yo, and may be able to adjust sa situation since bago ka lang naman po dun yung culture and everything, yung for me po kasi resilient and flexible naman ako in terms of that. And I hope after ilang years, sana same pa rin si Laikan na ngayon sa pag nasa US na. Ayun.
Wow. Don't worry, Miss Laika, no? 5 years from now, no, we will interview you again. Let's see, no? Kasi pa rin si Laika. 5 years from now, no? Kidding aside, no? How about you, Miss April, no? Do you have any concerns or anxieties right now about this journey or path na napili mo for your future?
Ayun, sa totoo po, meron din. Kasi as a typical Filipina naman who grew here in the Philippines, I'm not confident with my accent, with the way I converse with foreigners. Minsan kasi parang okay naman. Alam ko naman yung grammar, alam ko naman mag-English, pero pag nagsalita na sila, parang pardon, sorry. Kaya parang isa yun sa mga anxiety ko, lalo kapag nag-work na doon as a PT. Siyempre, extra challenge yun na foreigners talaga yung makakaharap. Tapos, minsan din naiisip ko yung height ko, ganon. Syempre, iba doon. Pero I find relief naman in thinking of overcoming it through practice, seeking help from my colleagues. Parang sabi ni Ma'am Laika na may support system naman. And looking at it is a challenge, no, for my career growth. At saka natutuwa din ako na si Grandison, yun nga, may offer siya na parang may give back muna tayo. So habang nandun, parang feel ko safe ako kasi at least kung nasan ako nag-work, alam kong may kapit ako doon eh, parang gano'n. Inalagaan nila ako habang nasa Pinas pa ako, gano'n.
Yes, and definitely agree, no? And I think, bibigyang din ko lang din siguro, no? Because I've heard this from a lot of PTs about the anxiety, yung support system, no? I think that's also one advantage of having peers, no, katulad ngayon dalawa, no, no, we don't know, no, baka future besties na kayo in the United States, no, but I think that's one of the key differences, no, of a self-finance PT papuntang United States and someone who's processing with an agency, kasi you get to meet other PTs who have the same journey with you, no, you get to share as well your concerns and your anxieties, and iba yon kapag meron kang support system, no. And yun yung pinakamasayang part din, no, like with what Miss April said earlier, no, during the time that you're processing or reviewing with Grandison, no, you also have the time to practice your career as a PT here in the Philippines. Yan, because the review schedules, you can choose from morning or evening classes, no, so it's really a give back then to the community that you can still be able to practice, no, while still focusing or working on your future dreams and aspirations. Ayan, no? And, okay, next, before I go down to the next question, no, medyo marami kasi tayong viewers ngayon, no? So, hello to the 28,000 viewers. No? So, for the June 2024 PTLE passers who are watching right now, just stay tuned, no? In a while po, we will be drawing, no? Mag-raffle na po tayo ng 10,000 pesos cash reimbursement winner natin. Of course, Miss April and Miss Laika is also part ng mga i-raffle natin later, no? Along with the other June 2024 passers na nag-submit ng entries nila. Ayan, no? So, how about you, Miss Lori? Do you have any questions for Miss April and Miss Laika?
Yes, meron ako. Bali, ano to? Mahirap-hirap. Ay, may ganun. Hirap-hirap yeah. Ay, carry yan, no? So, for the two of you, no? So, I just want to ask, no? So, do you have any specific areas ba in physical therapy that you would like to focus on, no? Pagdating nyo sa US, no? Or in the US healthcare system? And ano yung mga naka-influence sa inyo, no? As to why you want to consider this specialization? Ayan, so si Miss April.
Ayan. For me, ma'am, meron po. Gusto ko mag-specialize sa neurology. Kasi mula nung bata ako, talagang fascinated na talaga ako sa brain, spinal cord, ganyan. Tapos very good thing that in PT, I have this chance to specialize in the field even if I am not a medical doctor. Tapos nag-a-add pa yung parang, wow, sa US ko pa yun, mapupursue, ganyan.
Yes, di ba? Napakahirap nun, mama. Neuro. Pero yes. Kaya yan.
Surugan no? Pala to eh.
Serious like ka. Ano sa'yo, ma'am?
Ako po, ano, I see myself handling pedia and or geria patients. Although may love and hate relationship ako sa pedia, pero why not? Masarap ang feels. Pero ayun po, actually, may kinda bet din po ako sa neuro, pero I see myself specifically siguro sa pedia, yon. Pero sa US kasi, di ba, yung bulk ng cases nila, usually geria, and lalo na sa skilled nursing, di ba? Lalo na sa my grandison. So, I'm also good with that. And for me kasi, parang, parang sarap sa feeling kapag yung mga bata o mga matatanda yung mga kinikater mo. Parang, alam mo, feel mo, nagigive back ako sa mga lola-lolo ko, mga ganon. And for me naman, open naman ako sa ibang field. Kasi I don't want to, parang i-focus ko sarili ko, dito lang ako. Kasi paano mag-grow as a person if I would limit myself sa ganong specific specialization lang. So, ayun po.
Ayan. So, may pagkakaibang ating chosen specialization, no? So, another question, no? So, what advantages do you see in practicing physical therapy in the US, no? Compared to other countries? So, bakit sa US? Ayan, so si Miss Laika.
Actually, just to be honest, una kasi, ang first choice ko is Australia. Kasi sabi ko, ay, gusto ko na Australia kasi work-life balance, ganyan, New Zealand and stuff like that. Tapos sabi ko, pero sabi ko, nung inisip-isip ko, parang mas competitive, I think, kapag nag-US ako kasi mas broad, mas maganda yung healthcare system, mas yung types of cases, mas variety siya ng mga cases na pag nahawakan ko, mas mabibuild, mas mag-grow yung skills ko as a PT po. Ayun.
Ayan. So, in short, no, sa US kasi malawak yung market nyo as a physical therapist. Diba? So, Miss April, ikaw naman. Bakit
yes, ma'am,
US?
I agree with Ma'am Laika na diverse talaga yung patient doon sa US. Kasi nga, mas malaki siya, mas maraming opportunity din. And also, isang consideration ko din talaga is yung cost of living. So, unlike other countries na mataas nga yung salary, mataas din naman yung cost of living. Yung iba mababa naman ang cost of living, mababa din naman yung sahod. So, nakita ko na yung US, competitive yung salary nito. Tapos yung cost of living, medyo average siya. Hindi naman siya super taas. Di rin naman super baba. So, parang nakita ko na mag-grow ako doon. Tsaka may enjoy ko yung dream workplace ko talaga.
Ayan, it's
hashtag
nice to
dream
hear,
workplace,
no?
No?
Dream workplace, no? US. Diba? So, Eto naman, share your long-term aspirations in the US. So it can be about the career, house, travel, or car, kung ano man yung mga hashtag long-term goals nyo in life, no? So, and in 10 years from now, no, na sana ma-achieve nyo. Ayan, so Miss April.
Ako po, unang-una dyan is yung career. Siyempre, yun naman yung dahilan ba't ako puntang US. So, gusto ko talaga maging holistically developed neurologic PT sa US. Hopefully, ma-promote din sa higher position sa department, di ba? Kasi hindi, sana hindi lang staff forever. Next naman is yung car. Kasi sabi nga po, parang wala namang trike doon, wala namang jeep. So, as time goes by, gusto ko sanang mag-travel din conveniently papunta sa work. Tapos, lastly, yung house para, siyempre, pag siyempre, ipipetition yung mga kapamilya. Kahit pa paano, may matitirhan na sila doon. Ayun.
Exactly. At least
experience namin yung White Christmas.
Yes. Exactly, ma'am. No? At least doon, no? Para nakikita mo yung self mo na established, no? Sa US, diba? And ikaw, Miss Laika.
Same lang din naman po kami ni Ma'am April, but I have this long-term goal na tagline. Sabi, my long-term goal would be PT Laika will be able to establish a rehabilitation clinic and rehab charity in the Philippines while being the US after 10 years. Ayun. Although it may sound idealistic, but who knows, diba? Sabi nila, kung mag-dream ka, taasan mo na. And
exactly.
Yes,
if you work
I agree.
Exactly. At least, di ba, may napupuntahan, may pinaglalaanan ang mga paghihirap. Di ba? And
saka
it's really
may
nice
give
to
back,
know.
No?
Oo. Di ba? It's really nice to know that at the end of the day, yung end goal natin is to, you know, give back, no? Not just for our family, but also for other people who needs our help then. Ayan. So, next question. Eto na. No? So, this is the last question from my end, no? So, of course, no, we want to promote PTs to practice here in the Philippines before anything else. So, as a Filipino physical therapist, how do you see yourself contributing to both the professional community and the Filipino diaspora within the healthcare landscape? Ayan. Grabing term, no? Diaspora? Napa-search ako bigla. So, Miss Laika.
About that po, yun din, same din halos sa sinabi ko kanina, yung main highlight would be charity. Kasi both yan eh, parang dalawa na rin yung nabibuild ko dyan. Besides sa may matutulungan ako sa rehab, kasi rehab charity yung bet ko po na gawing charity. So, before that kasi, syempre, before ka magtayo ng charity, kailangan mo ng finances. And how could I do that without establishing myself first sa maging successful sa US para ma-materialize ko yung gusto kong ma-impart sa mga Filipino people. So, for me po, mas although maganda siya pakinggan, pero you need to, ano din po, parang at some point, unahin mo muna sarili mo and then dun ka mag-give back kapag alam mong capable ka na. Kasi mahirap mag-give up, give back kung ano yung gi-give back mo kung sa sarili mo kulang ka pa. Ayun.
Yes, di ba? And there's nothing impossible na ngayon, ma'am. Basta may pangarap tayo. So,
yes.
Miss no? April, no? For you naman.
For me naman, ma'am, kung kay Miss Laika, parang long-term talaga yung tinitingnan niya. Ako naman, as of now, parang gusto ko na siyang start habang nandito ako. So, I am currently exploring the wide spectrum of PT practice. I'm into fitness, rehab, at saka syempre nga home care. Kasi I believe that breaking the stigma of PTs, kasi dati parang yung tingin, di ba, manghihilot, ganyan, massage. I believe that as of now na-explore ko yung spectrum ng PT practice, yung pag-break dun sa stigma, nakaka-contribute na ako sa professional community. And I am also looking forward to pursuing CPDs, ganyan, earning various certification, para may ma-impart din ako sa future generation. At saka, ayun din, after siguro nga experience with the US, syempre pag tumatanda ka, minsan gusto mong bumalik kung saan ka nanggaling. Doon, at least kahit papano, may ma-impart ako sa mga susunod naman na magiging PT sa Pilipinas at the same time sa US din.
Grabe,
Ayan.
pinapakinggan ko yung mga sagot nila,
Yan po,
no? Nakaka-proud.
nakaka-inspire.
Yes, nakaka-proud, no? And I'm very happy that nakilala namin kayo and that you became part of Grandison as well, no? I'm very excited na, no? For your future, no? And speaking of that, no? Speaking of your future, no? For other aspiring Filipino PTs, no? Who may be just like you, pwedeng kaka-graduate lang nila last year or maybe someone who just finished their degree this June 2024, no? And maybe confused pa rin sila, no, kung should I choose to advance my career in the United States, no? And still wondering, no, kung saan sila pupunta or might be considering nga yung US, no? What advice or insights can you give them? Should they follow their heart? Yan. I guess I'll start with Miss April kasi si Miss Lai kayong naunahan nina, no? Okay. Yan. Miss April.
Siguro, ang advice ko, first of all, they should pray for it muna. Wag i-follow yung heart agad kasi diba sabi din, the heart is deceitful. So, do not be deceived. Clear your mind muna. Tapos, i-weigh lahat. Ano ba yung gusto mo talaga? And then, pero ano ba yung mas kailangan mo? So, hindi na kasi practical ngayon yung gusto mo lang. Kailangan yung makatotohanan din talaga. Then, slowly condition yourself and accept your decision and start as early as you can. So, isa siguro yun sa main highlight ng advice ko yun nga. Start as early as you can. At saka, pag sinimulan mo na, panindigan mo na. Huwag ka nang mag-what if. Huwag mo nang balikan yung, ano kaya kung ito kayo, yung tinay ko, hindi ako nag- ganto ganyan. So, dapat, yun na yun. Dun ka na. Kasi pag para sa'yo talaga.
Yes, amen.
There's no turning
no?
back.
Well, before I ask Miss Laika no, for her answer, no, I want to highlight no, yung takeaways ko din from what Miss April mentioned no, or answered earlier. No. Don't just follow your heart. Weigh in if it's something that you need. No? Kasi you need to weigh in your wants and needs, eh, di ba? Tinuturo rin yun sa school, no? Part of our psychology
yes,
class din yan, right? No? And once you start, no, sabi nga niya, start as early as you can, no? Kasi syempre mag-review ka pa ng NPTE. There are licensure exams that you need to take, no? And you can take opportunity or advantage na medyo fresh pa yung knowledge of the recent PTLE, no? So as early na mag-start ka, no, mas possible maging mas easier din yung pag-review for NPTE, no? And once you're there, commitment.
Yes,
no?
There's no turning back.
Yes, commitment, no. Later I'll elaborate din yung commitment further, pero gusto ko munang marinig si Miss Laika, no. What advice can you give to the PTs, Miss Laika, who are still wondering, no, or confused, no, if they should follow their sabi nga mag-follow their heart, follow their heart. Pag US ba ako? Magaganto ba ako? Okay. Go po, Miss Laika.
Actually, medyo same kami ng process kung paano ko tinake tong opportunity ni Miss April. I don't know if it's same, but medyo similar. Kasi I also pray. Malapit ako kay Lord. Hindi kasi ano po, before ka mag-decide, hindi naman laging ang puso. And hindi siya porket, ay, na-feel ko to. Kasi di ba pangit kapag pinapangunahan mo ng emotions yung mga decision-making mo. You need to also think. So, kapag na think ka na, nakapag-isip ka na ng logically kasi based sa situation mo, kung ano ba yung priorities mo, kung ano ba yung short term and long term goals mo, kung nag-a-align ba yon, if that happened then mag-pray ka, if then syempre may mga in the journey may hirapan ka pa, then you also seek guidance kasi if para nga sa'yo, para sa'yo. And sabi nga nila, hindi naman sa'yo bibigay yan ni Lord if hindi mo kaya. Ayun.
Yes, definitely agree, no, to both of our guests for today. I'm so happy na kayo na-invite namin for today. No, talaga ang ganda. Ang ganda ng mga sagot nila, no. And I think I'm down to the last question, actually, no. But before that, no, let me just plug. Pagbigyan niyo na po ako, Miss April and Miss Laika, no. Let me just promote as well the upcoming Grandison Espresso Lounge events for this month, no. So for the coming weeks, no, we have an free NPTE demo lecture happening next Friday, no. I think Miss April and Miss Laika just finished their bootcamp as well, No, so we will be having our free NPTE demo lecture next Friday. No, so just visit our page not to know how to register for that free demo lecture. Plus, meron din kaming free NPTE review raffle. No, so hindi pa nga tapos yung 10K raffle. There's another raffle coming in. No, and that's worth 56,000 pesos review. No, and this is open to all BSPTs. No, grandison ka man or hindi. Yan. And aside from that, no, we will also be having a series of webinars, no, about how a Filipino BSPT or how a Filipino licensed PT can migrate, no, and work to the United States. So we have some topics about the differences of ECR, NYZ, and ICD. No, that's one topic that we're going to discuss. Kasi medyo maraming confused right now. Eh. Ano ba yung path na kailangan kong kunin? Because there are also issues eh, na tinatanggap po ba ang 5 years sa US, no? And yon, we want to debunk that, no? Because yes, no, 4 years is still accepted in the United States. Yan. So we will be answering that question in one of our webinars in a few weeks. And of course, we will also differentiate the PT and PTA pathway to the United States. So of course, just visit our page, no, to know the exact dates, no, and to register for the events. And of course, no, going back to the last question. Sorry, Miss April and Miss Laika for the commercial, no. In terms of building your legacy, no, or looking ahead, what kind of impact do you hope to make as a Filipino physical therapist in the United States? Yan, what legacy do you aim to leave behind? Syempre, dapat yung pang-finale question natin pang pang-miss pang-halawa or pang-miss universe then, right? No. So what legacy do you want to leave behind? I'll start with Miss Laika.
Pressure naman yun. Thank you for that last
one.
Yes. For me, syempre, hindi lang naman tayo bias sa Filipino na magi-give back sa Filipino community. Why not also give back sa US community? Kasi diba, ando doon ka na rin naman nag-work. And then, syempre maganda yung may trademark lagi yung Filipino na kapag Filipino PT, maalaga, consistent, may puso sa mga pasyente. And kasi, di ba mga Asian, mapuso yung mga Asian people, lalo ng mga Filipino. And in terms of that, kasi kapag ano ka sa patient, parang hindi naman sa totally attached ka sa patient, but if you have passion in what you're doing, mararamdaman yun ng patient. And I think it could also aid sa pag-recover nila and yung in terms of mental ability ng patient mo to para gumaling sila sa current condition nila. So parang na-vibrate mo sa kanila yung character mo, kumbaga, ganon.
Yes, no? That very lovely answer, Miss Laika. Thank you so much for that, no? And how about you po, Miss April?
I think ngayon, ma'am, confirmed na Pinay talaga kami ni ma'am Laika kasi pareho kami ng parang insights dun sa tanong. So, ako naman, I want to leave my mark kasi, which I also acquired from one of my best mentor. Yung mark na yun is, binigyan niya na meaning yung PP, which is P for promoting health, tapos yung T while touching lives. So, gusto kong dalhin yun sa US. As a Filipino PT, I want to impart our innate character. Yun nga, maalaga, maasikaso, empathic. We do not just do the work kasi we immerse ourselves into the patient's lives. Tapos, gusto ko na parang ma-achieve nila yung maximal functional capacity nila through that holistic approach. Tapos, if not too much, kung sakali lang naman, I also want to write a guidebook or tips journal regarding Filipino PTs in the US that would surely help the next generation naman.
Wow.
Yes.
May balak maging author.
Yes.
Magiging ano pa, author pa siya.
Yes, no. And I think that wraps up all of our questions for today, no? Para sa inyong dalawa, Miss April and Miss Laika. It was a very awesome and lovely time talking
yes.
with you, no? Na-enjoy ko yung interview natin today, no? I love the answers, no? And grabe para sila nag-uusap sa isip nila. No, kasi yeah,
mukhang mag-best friend na talaga kayo.
Yun po, no? Maraming salamat once again, Miss Laika and Miss April.
Thank you po, ma'am.
Thank you po, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you po.
Maraming salamat too. And ingat po sa pag-drive, Miss April. Ayan.
Thank you.